It's been said that in this very cemetery, there's some really strange things that go on. We're looking for Kingsley Old, who drowned the two girls that was assassinated in the jail. And we're told that those two girls are buried by him. Now, why would any father let the murderer of his two girls be buried next to him for eternity? Now, that doesn't really make any sense, but then again, maybe that's proof that Kingsley didn't. You know, one of the theories is that even though they knew he didn't kill them, they really felt he was still responsible because he was a work hand on the ranch, and now he knew these people, so it wasn't like he didn't know them. Now, whether it's true or not, the truth of the matter is he is supposed to be buried here right in earshot of the two girls, which is kind of strange and morbid in itself. But you know what? Aren't all these stories strange and morbid? And that's just one of the stories of the ghosts that haunt the Old Globe Jail. Oh, welcome. You know, a lot of people creep up on you in the cemetery, so you got to kind of watch out. You know, we know it's going to be getting dark here soon, and we're going to be in the old jail. And, you know, we're thinking about why the people that decided to be there are there still. Who are they? You know, we don't want to know it was the lady in red. We want to know, what was the lady's name? What was she like? Is there a reason that she's stuck here? Because maybe the life that she lived, right? That's what we want to know, is why are they there? You know, did they live a life? Were they, you know, were they bad people? Were they just confused? Were they addicted to some substance that, you know, I mean, why are we here? And that's why it's so important that when you go into these facilities, these haunted locations, that you know who you're looking and dealing with, right? That's only fair. So we're not ghost hunters. You know, we're interested in history. And will history help us be able to relate to what a lot of people call the other side? I don't know if I want to be here in this cemetery. If you haven't been in the Globe Cemetery, when it's creepy in the day, you damn sure it's creepy at night. And when you walk through this jail, now those bars came from another jail in Yuma. So if there's been any residual spiritual experience that came from that, this jail was destined to doom from the day it was put together. And you can feel that when you walk through this facility. It's really a heavy experience. And when you walk upstairs, it gets even heavier. Now, there was a man that was assassinated within this jail named Kingsley Olds. Like there, did you hear that?
Yeah.
Okay, well, at least I wasn't just hearing it. I mean, it kept... So we want to know their stories. I mean, we're not here to taunt them. We're not here to you know, raise hell. We're basically here, let me know what your story is. James is trying, they're trying to find James's story now. So we're trying to here to figure out what, you know, what's the truth.
Why would you stay here if you didn't have to after, you know, some kind of traumatic death and experience in this place? I'll tell you straight up, this place is terrifying. One, it's a jail. Two, it's incredibly old, dark, and creaky. And three, there's a lot of people who will tell you it is haunted, and they will tell you specific experiences they've had. And once that gets working in your brain and you're in a dark cell by yourself, it definitely takes hold of you. And whether it's mind tricks or actual, you know, paranormal activity, I can't say for sure, but it scares the death out of me. So here we are, and I guess we're gonna go upstairs now. So wish us luck.
Whoa.
What? Well, I've got this. It's
definitely Just, things start moving in this place. Real war imagine is terrifying.
Well, you know what we're hoping is that we get somebody to talk with us tonight. You know, we probably, the thing about it, so let's go up here. That is a ghost they put in the window. Now, here is Kingsley Ole's jail cell right here. Okay?
It's obviously not him.
He was assassinated through these windows on the third floor, shot through those windows up there, in here, and killed on this very spot. That is unbelievable that that could even happen. So he was killed right here. So would he be here? Well, I mean, I can see that. Now, here's something creepy too. James, grab this, would you? Here's something scary too, okay? So he's in here with a gunshot wound, and they don't know if he drowned the girls or not. He states that somebody ambushed him, shot him, drowned the girls. That's what he told them. They kind of believe that, you know what? If he was still responsible for him, so even if he didn't kill him, somebody was going to pay, and he just happened to be the guy here. Well, that next night, someone goes into the courthouse, which is across the street, and we'll show you that. Comes in across the street, goes to the third floor window, and shoots across the alley through this very site, and then through this window over here. And he shoots through this window, right there, through these bars. There's two sets of bars, right? Shoots him and kills him. So he's assassinated in jail from across the street in that window right there. Now, if that wouldn't bring ghosts, then I don't know what would. Now let's talk about another thing. Let's talk about the fact that he believed that the two little girls that were dead came to this cell right here, this location exactly, came here. And what did they do? They wanted him to come with them, and they scared the holy hell out of him. But he said they came to him twice in this very cell, in this very location. And then he was assassinated right there. That is absolutely incredible. Getting a weird vibe up here, James. So, this is a dummy here, but this is basically showing the exact location that Kingsley Ole left his maker.
like moving with you.
Well, how's that? Now it's not. There's nothing there. It's still there?
It is still there.
Well, I got it's no light.
It's right above the corner of the door now.
Like here, follow me.
Watch, I'm moving the camera around. And it's squiggling all over the place.
I mean, this was the light, right?
Yeah. Oh, it's still it's above the door. Whoa.
Let me see. It's got to be the camera.
I mean, I'm imagining this has to be something to do with the lens. I don't know, man.
The Irishman here. Can somebody sing for me? Somebody sing me a tune. Can somebody give me a couple good notes? There's got to be somebody in here. One thing about it is, you know, it's got to be fairly good echo.
I did sing for you.
Yeah, we did. James did here. Remember us from the movie? You jacked up all my shots? Probably thought that was funny. You know, and the only place that kind of scares me is right here.
Yeah.
I don't know if it scares me, but they say the magnetic field here is the highest in the building also, in this location. Is that you?
Yeah, that's okay. Me, because I'm scared right now.
Oh, okay. Somebody in one of these cells?
Oh. Something made noise back there. Easily could have been just us, but...
Like I said, with most of these places, though, James, you know, I'm more afraid of somebody coming in from the outside and somebody being in here now.
I agree. Yeah. As with everywhere we go, it's far more scary the currently living people.
I guess they could scare me into a heart attack.
Ah, don't like that. Get that back on. Get that back on.
I honestly didn't do that.
Yeah, okay. Don't like that at all.
Wonder what it was.
Me too.
I'm serious. I did not touch this.
Yeah, I know you didn't. I know you didn't. That's why I don't want to be over here in the dark.
See, here's the button here.
Yeah, and you didn't touch it.
And I honestly didn't touch it.
I believe you.
I thought the battery died. I think it's dying.
It's dying. Okay.
Yeah,
I don't want to be out here in the dark because I'm going to break this camera.
Don't break the camera.
Yeah, and I just don't want to snap the
Wait a minute. Well, let me see. I mean, if it's going to end, yeah, it's going out.
Okay, that's just good news because.
Did I have a battery or did I not? Okay.
Dude.
Oh. I'm here with you, so it's not like we're... Oh, yeah. I'm going to turn a little light on just so the camera can at least get a little bit of a glimpse of us so they'll please see where we are here. Is anybody in here like to talk with us?
That's just like something turning off.
Was that an exhale like a...
Maybe it was like machinery or something?
Maybe we're not good paranormal people, James. Maybe they don't like us.
It's definitely not our strong suit.
You know, I always try to remember, you know, I always think what it'd be like to be in here, you know. It's a good reason not to be in here, not to do stupid shit. Good reminder. I mean, the building's just a building. The building ain't got nothing to do with it. It's the evil people that are in it.
Thank you.
Now, this is the cell that Kingsley Owles was murdered in.
Yeah, like right there.
Right in front of us.
Basically, the camera is where he was shot.
So we know this, you know, if there should be something here.
One would think so.
Now, if there was a reason for him to be here, I could get that, right? Not want to be here, but be here.
Yeah. And supposedly the little girls
were right outside there.
Were right outside that cell door and visited him. I mean, they had a reason to visit him, according to the story. But, yeah.
Little girls, do you ever come here? At least we know who you are. Lulu?
Lulu is one of them.
Yeah.
I don't remember the sister's name. But
I'd like to think they're not here, you know?
I would like to think that was... Because they said come along with us, according to Kingsley. So hopefully they got to go to a better place.
Yeah, I don't wish anybody to be stuck here. You know, me and James fight our own demons as far as ever ending up in a place like this. And that's what I get out of this too, is that I don't want to be here. I can leave the door cells open, right? The door's open. We can leave anytime we want. We're here by choice to be able to show people and investigate this and see what's there. Because what I got a weird feeling is that we got all kinds of activity on that microphone, that's what I think. You know, I think that we have all kinds of action on that microphone. I really do. We're just not getting it here. We're not hearing it. But I believe you're here. I mean, too many people have seen stuff here. Too many people have felt stuff here. You know, you have to be here. But it would help me, and you would help James, if you would come out and give us something.
You can go downstairs. I'm going to stay in here for
you. You're going to do it by yourself?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
I have to.
I really don't feel comfortable leaving you, to be honest.
Somebody has to do this.
You can even go outside if you want.
Somebody's got to be up here. Somebody's got to be up here.
Man.
I got to see if there's something up here.
Alright, man.
You want to come over and touch me? Go ahead. James went outside, so I'm in the building by myself. He didn't want to come up here and do this by himself. One of us had to, though. I mean, I'm not comfortable doing it, but somebody's got to do it. It's kind of weird when you're in a building by yourself, an entire three-story building, you know, that's supposed to be haunted by yourself. There is a cell. I saw the guy sitting in when we were shooting this movie, and in that cell, he was sitting in that chair. Right there. Oh, Jesus Christ. What the hell was that? I guess that face. Somebody walking. Probably James. James, are you? James. James, you up here? Are you in the building?
So James, what'd you think, man?
It wasn't as scary. I still don't want to be in there by myself.
It was pretty interesting. I when that breath, what I thought was breath on my neck scared the shit out of me. I saw an orb when you were playing guitar. And we run about 4 hours worth of video solid in different places. So there could be a hell of a lot of stuff that we are going to see on the video.
We didn't see or hear ourselves, yeah. Exactly.
Because that orb came out when you were playing the guitar, I didn't get that. But it definitely did. It came right out of that jail cell, which I saw the guy sitting in last time I was here.
Yeah.
Didn't see him, though. They weren't, as active. I say that, but...
We don't know.
We don't know. I mean, they weren't active to us as much, but,
I'm interested in seeing if you see that door footage I got on the GoPro.
Where the door was actually opening.
Where the door was moving. So that'd be interesting.
Yeah, that'll be absolutely interesting. So, hey, we'll see what we got. I mean, I walked the entire thing by myself, and it was... I wouldn't do it for fun. It wouldn't be like the fun thing I would do. Hey, you want to go in the jail by yourself? No. But
upstairs, because I told him at the beginning of this, I am not sitting upstairs anywhere by myself. I don't even like being downstairs by myself in this building, to be honest. I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but that door is moving back and forth on its own right now. There is an air conditioner behind me, but it wasn't doing that before. My whole body is covered in chills.
played for this kind of audience.
When dying time comes, don't you weep for me. 'Cause I found my maker down on bended knee. And I live this life just the way I please. When dying time comes, don't you weep for me. You won't ever catch me a-whistling through the night. Once I start a-walking, I'm walking in the light. This is